What's going on, everybody? Welcome to a new video. In this one, I wanted to go over what I thought was a brilliant red zone play from Serious Moe this past weekend from the Muthead League Season 5 playoffs, where he ended up winning the whole thing. This year in Madden 19, if you didn't know, the high ball is definitely back, and this play does a great job of just maximizing your high ball opportunities and putting your opponent's user defender in an awkward position where they basically have to pick one receiver or the other. As long as you make the right read, a lot of times this play is going to work out for you. So I just saw him run this setup a few times. I thought it was a really smart setup, and I just wanted to kind of showcase it in this video. So if we roll it a little bit, you could see we're in the gun bunch formation. He motions out Randy Moss. And so what you want to know here is the play he's running is called verticals. And so a lot of people, I'm sure, are familiar with gun bunch verticals. But in this case, he motions out Randy Moss on the wheel route. And that's really the primary thing you need to notice, is that Moss is going to be running that wheel route into the corner of the end zone. That's really your first high point read. Now, you're going to notice Blocky ends up throwing a lot of attention over to Moss on that wheel route. And that's kind of what makes this play run, is the fact that your opponent has to respect that route so much. So you're going to see Blocky's got two guys over there, in the flat. One's manned up on Moss, one's in a flat zone. And then you also have another guy sitting right here who's kind of in between. So he's being pulled more towards the wheel side because of the fact that he's stretching out that zone. So you've got essentially three guys who have their attention over there on Randy Moss. And so that's really what makes this play tick and what makes the other routes so good and opens them up. But the other things you're going to see is that on the backside, he's got a shallow crossing route coming over the middle. Over the middle, you have the default deep crossing route from Gun Bunch Vertical. So he's going to have a guy crossing in the back of the end zone. And then he puts his tight end on what's going to be a curl route. Just sit down right there. And so you're going to see as this play develops what exactly happens and why that route combo is so good. So if we roll it just a little bit, so now Blocky, if you notice Blocky's user defender, he's in the right spot. You know, he can't really play this any better than what he's playing it. He's in the right spot. He's sitting right here over the middle of the field, but now he has a decision to make, right? He needs to decide, do I run with the deep crossing route that's going to be going in the back of the end zone, or do I stop and try and defend this curl route that's sitting down in a perfect spot because, you know, I've got three defenders over here on the right side, pretty much all looking at Moss. And so I need to decide which one I want to stay with. Now, in this case, both of those routes over the middle are now high point options for Moe. You can high point the curl route as he turns around, or you can high point the deep crossing route in the back of the end zone. So this is what I'm talking about, where, you know, it really stretches that user defender and puts him under a lot of stress, where he's got to make a decision now. He's got to try and basically bait you into making the wrong read. If you make the right read in this case, it's going to be a touchdown, you know, 99 times out of 100 in this scenario. And so, as you see, camera rolls a little bit more. Blocky runs with the deep crosser and tries to circle back around. The way momentum works in this game, it's tough to do something like that. Blocky did a great job of it, in this case, circling back and trying to make a play. But also, if we roll it just a little bit more, so Moe throws that high point, but another thing I want to bring your attention to is the underneath crossing route. And so not only, so it stresses the user defender twice. So, right? So it stretches them in the back of the end zone between the curl route and the deep crossing route. But then say they peel off to the curl route like Blocky did. But now if Moe would have waited like a quarter of a second longer, now the user's got to decide, well, do I sit and stay on the, you know, curl route in the back of the end zone? That's an easy high point. Or do I play aggressively underneath on the crossing route that's coming in underneath it? So not only does he get stretched between the deep cross and the curl, but now between the curl and the underneath crosser. So just the way these routes combine with each other and mesh very, very well, it's a nightmare to defend. And it all kind of extends from that outside wheel route by Randy Moss, as you see, because he occupies so many defenders, it puts you in an awkward position over the middle of the field as a user. So Moe ends up going, he sees Blocky go with the deep cross and he throws that high point curl route. Blocky can't get back in time, actually gets back, you know, reasonably well, is able to make a play on the ball with Vernon Davis, but Vernon Davis is able to hold on, and that's going to give Moe a touchdown. He goes up 24-0, the game's essentially over at that point. But I just thought that was a brilliant setup from Moe, and how he gives himself, you know, three high point options. And it's not just, you know, three high points that are just sitting still in the end zone. It's three high points that are all meshing with each other to open up other routes and every single route on the play is really a viable option, which is very rare in the red zone. A lot of times in the red zone, you know, you're basically looking for one or two guys on a given play, and if they're not open, you're throwing the ball away. But right there, Moe's got four viable options, and it makes that red zone play in particular a nightmare to defend. But that's going to do it for this video, guys. As always, thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed, and until next time, take it easy.